Good evening, and welcome to Shawnee Mission Sports. I'm Reed Williams, along with Matt Owens and Grant Cole. We are at Shawnee Mission Northwest High School for the second game of our doubleheader. We just saw the girls of Shawnee Mission Northwest beat the Lady Indians, and now it's time for the men of Northwest to take on the men of North. The Indians are 15-4 overall and 11-0 in district play this season, under head coach Steven Steitzer, who hopes to be heading back in the state tournament. Mike Rose and his Cougars are 7-12 and 5-8 in district. Should be a fun rivalry mashup. Let's take a look at some key players for the Indians.
Well, first up, we've got number 24, Michael Weathers. He's a 6'3" senior and has the all-time scoring record at Shawnee Mission North. And he broke that record last season. He's one of the captains and the starting point guard. He's a great three-point shooter, and he scored 17 and 18 points in his first two varsity games. I'm sure we'll get to see some great aerial action from Michael tonight. Along with Michael, we have his brother, Marcus. He's his twin brother, and he's the senior post. He measures up at 6'5", and he's the leading rebounder at Shawnee Mission North. And he's the second leading scorer. He sure can light up a crowd.
For the Cougars, number 52, Dylan Dirks, also known as Mr. Hustle, on the court. He can shoot the three and drive the court. He reminds me a little bit of Brandy Rose, which you saw in the first game. He also has quick hands and a tough defensive player, while also being the leading scorer for the Cougars. Dylan and Austin won't be far from each other next year, as they've signed with Nebraska and Wesleyan University and will be playing basketball there next year. There's Ferdinand Handy, who is a point guard this year and has started every single game. He transferred to Northwest last season has fit in very well with the program. He's the second leading scorer on the team and has quickness and handles to drive the lane and hit the shot. Our X factor for Shawnee Mission Northwest is Jalen Lede. He averages over 8 points a game, and he's only started since the second semester. He's taken a little bit to get in his rhythm, but lately he is showing why he is a great player. He also shoots 49% from the floor.
Moving for the X factor for Shawnee Mission North, I'd say it's Brendan Henderson. See, if he can get hot from behind the arc, it'll really spread Northwest defense thin. It'll open up a lot of really easy looks down low for his team.
Keys to the game for Northwest. First, stop the Weathers brothers. If they go off, this game's over. Second, attack the offense in the paint. Don't look outside for three-pointers. Go in hard and get the easy points. And also, don't turn the ball over. You turn the ball over, the Weather brothers are going to run the court and score easy baskets.
And I'm going to keep my key to North's victory. They have to get to an early lead. This season, when North gets off to a big lead early, they're able to get into that high-flying, three-point draining offense that they enjoy and we all love so much.
Those are just a couple keys to the game. I'm sure there's going to be a lot more in this game. I'm ready. This is going to be an exciting matchup between the two teams.
Definitely.
And you know, I mean, Shawnee Mission North, they're 6-1 in away games. And coming into a hostile environment where Shawnee Mission Northwest is 3-5 at home, you know, I feel like North, I mean, it's a rivalry game. Nobody looks over anybody, no matter what the record may be. And Shawnee Mission Northwest, they've really been on a streak. They're really doing well. And I mean, I don't know. I feel like anything could happen.
That is true. In rivalry games, anything can happen. This game shall be a great matchup between two teams who don't particularly like each other very much.
Definitely.
Another key point for Ferdinand Handy. He leads the team. As coming out on the court right now are the two are the two honor junior Cougars who have read books for their team, and they have qualified to sit on the bench with the team. What a great experience for those young kids. As we are about ready to throw it over to the PA announcer for starting lineups.
American support troops are fighting for our freedom at home and abroad. Will you please rise for our national anthem? For the Indians, number 2, Will Schneider. For your Northwest Cougars, a senior, number 15, Joe Specht. For Shawnee Mission North, number 5, Marcus Weathers. For your Northwest Cougars, number 22, Monik Kapoor. For the Indians, number 13, Avante Williams. For your Northwest Cougars, a senior, number 23, Zach Smith. For the Indians, number 15, Brendan Henderson. For your Northwest Cougars, a senior, number 32, Austin Sanders. And finally, for the Indians, number 24, Michael Weathers. And finally, for your Shawnee Mission Northwest Cougars, a senior, number 52, Dylan Dirks.
As the crowd is in full swing tonight. Two good crowds, both from Northwest and North, showing off whiteout from Northwest and blackout from Northwest. As we are ready for some Sunflower League basketball, I think some of the best basketball in the state. Wouldn't you guys agree?
Absolutely.
Yeah, definitely. No doubt about that. Northeast Kansas, honestly, in any sport, basketball, baseball, football, definitely a lot of good college recruits come out of this area of the entire Midwest. So
I very much agree. And we're going to see some great showcases tonight, as both Michael, the Weathers brothers, have been recruited by D1 schools. This should be a special night, as here we go for the tip. As Austin Sanders hits the Manic Kapoor and Dylan Dirks with the ball. As back out to Jamie Fisher, Manic Kapoor at the end. A new starting lineup this time. Joe Speck is his first start of the year. So does Manic Kapoor, along with the regulars, Austin Sanders and Dylan Dirks. As again, trying to find down low, Austin Sanders in the post, and they get stripped by North.
Here comes Marcus Weathers down the floor. They're going to set up an offense here. Dribble move, pass to Michael. Kicked out for the three and off the rim. Rebounded by Michael. Off the drive, kicks it back up to his brother, who's going to, well, it looks like he was about to pull up for a three. Kicks back out to Michael, and he drains the three. Boom goes the dynamite.
As Dirks got decked on there, no call, not a blocker charge. As Dirks, he also takes the ball up. He took a little hard hit. Looks to be okay. As Sanders pass it now. To Zach Smith. Dylan Dirks at the end. He's going to try to drive. Nice move, and he leaves it a little bit short. Manic Kapoor down there, and it's out of bounds. It'll stay with Shawnee Mission Northwest. Great job by Manic Kapoor down there getting the offensive rebound. As it looks like Joe Speck will throw in the ball. Pass it back to Manic Kapoor. Manic Kapoor pump fakes, and not a good pass. But a great play by Zach Smith that can corral it. Austin Sanders down low, goes in, and is blocked.
Got stuffed like a turkey on Thanksgiving, folks.
That is true. Well, I do love a turkey on Thanksgiving. That's not what I like. This is there. He got rejected.
It looks like on that last play, it looks like he could have kicked it out for an easy three. But instead, it looks like they're about to turn it back over.
I believe they signaled Northwest ball, yes.
Oh, nope, not
Northwest
yet.
Northwest ball. Joe Speck again inbounds. A little deja vu. Back out to Zach Smith. Dylan Dirks with the ball. He pops a tray, and it goes off the rim. And not the shot you want. While Dylan can knock those down, you want to work inside.
Here comes Marcus driving down the floor. Pulling up Michael for another three, just short. Rebounded by Northwest.
And you can't leave him open like that very often. He's going to hit most of those. That's Dylan Dirks. Finds Joe Speck in the corner. Joe Speck driving in. Finds Austin Sanders. Great pass down low, but Manic Kapoor could not finish. And transition.
And Will Schneider makes the bucket. What a lay-in.
Northwest was jogging back. You cannot do that against this feisty North offense. Dylan Dirks carrying the ball up the court. As Manic Kapoor passes it. And that is an air ball by Joe Speck. He doesn't usually shoot those very much. And the crowd is it's giving him
another shot down low. Rebounded by Marcus. He's going up and he gets fouled hard. He's going to be shooting two here. All right, here we go. Michael shooting the first of two here.
He is a 60% free throw shooter as he makes the first one. Makes it 5-0. Jalen O'Day and Ferdinand Henny subbed in for Joe Speck and Manic Kapoor.
As you can see here, North is absolutely doing one of the keys that I mentioned earlier on, is they have gotten out to a nice quick lead here. Now let's see if they're going to be able to hold on to that and grow with it.
Yes, they are. Dylan Dirks holding the ball up. Down 7-0. Here we go. That's to Austin Sanders. Austin Sanders up high at Ferdinand Henny at the end of the perimeter. Taking back and resetting the offense. Zach Smith, the little pump fake and shot. And man, Northwest is colder than in Antarctica right now. They cannot hit anything.
Here goes my X Factor. Passing it down and for the easy layup by Avante.
That is 9-0. This game can get out of hand real quick if Northwest does not get a couple baskets right here. Dylan Dirks with the ball, trying to set up the offense here. As it is loud here by the opposing fans, they made a great showing tonight.
Oh boy,
and
here we go.
Turnover.
Holy cow. What a jam. Slamming and jamming, baby. Here we go. They are fired up here at Shawnee Mission Northwest.
As Michael Weathers just earned his degree from Duncan on U after that play right there.
Man, that play was more impressive than an Ivy League degree.
Man, great North coming out with a great start, 11-0.
It's like their record in the Sunflower League.
That is correct. Wow.
That is way to use that, Grant.
What a coincidence.
I'm thinking Brandy Rose should check in this game real quick before this game gets out of hand.
That sounds like a good idea.
Timeout by Mike Rose trying to settle down his kids. It looks like Jamie Fisher will check into the game. here we go. Northwest will inbound. Here you go, Northwest inbound. Jamie Fisher will take it up. As with 4:30 to go, is 11-0. As he almost traveled there, and
another turnover. Going up to Brendan Henderson. Cannot finish on the first shot.
Northwest is lucky that North did not score in that possession. They give the ball away. Luckily, they're able to play good transition defense and get the stop. That could have almost been another dunking on you right there. Right now, Jamie takes the ball up. And a weak pass to Dylan, but it gets to him. And that's Dylan at the perimeter. Passes the ball back to Jamie Fisher. Jamie Fisher looks around. Brendan Henny spots up for three. And hits the three from downtown. You want to get back in the game, that's how you do it. On the other end is a charge call on number 15, Brandon Henderson, as they're going to say he leaned his shoulder into Dirks, and they're going to give that a charge. Could this be the turning point in the game already?
3 minutes and 49 left in the first quarter. I don't think there's anything such as a turning point yet.
Well, I mean, it was 11-0, but now it's 3-11. That's out to Dirks, who can't hit the three, and that will be out of bounds, North ball.
I'm telling you, this game's already getting physical by both sides here. Both teams are really getting into this game early on. This is going to be quite the matchup.
If this game stays close throughout the whole course of the game, I will not be surprised if we see a couple technical fouls called later on.
Absolutely not.
North with the ball.
Here goes Marcus Weathers down on the corner. Kicks it back up to Avante, who kicks it out. Brendan Henderson with the three. There's my X factor at work. Let's see if he can keep that up.
A dagger.
That was indeed right there for the Northwest offense. And almost another turnover. Fernand driving.
Nice pass.
Dish and foul. They're going to give a push off. Great pass for Fernand Henny. Sets up the free throw opportunity for Austin Sanders.
That was a nice pass down low there.
Sanders shoots 59% from the free throw line. Not bad at all for a big man. His first shot hits it. And those are crucial. If you cannot hit free throws, you're not going to win games. Substitution for North.
And Austin Sanders is a 59% free throw shooter, so we'll see if he can sink this one.
As his second shot goes in and makes this, I believe, 5-14. Yep, 5-14.
Here we go, fast break down the floor. Michael Weathers up with the layup, misses, almost rebounded by his brother Marcus.
And then again, North will speed up the game. They like to do that, and they're going to catch Northwest off guard a couple times. Here comes the trap. Jalen Lode down low, and there is a foul called. Let's see who is on. Foul on number 2, Will Schneider. That is his first foul.
The three is missed and rebounded by North. Almost came down with the travel there. Marcus was able to hold on to it and get off to a good dribble. Driving in with the shot short, and there's a ton of Northwest Cougars right there to get the rebound.
As Dylan Dirks takes the ball up, Fernand Henny on the point guard spot. Fernand Henny trips and falls.
Ooh.
Throws
it
away.
Right into the hands.
Here we go.
But good defense. Even though it was a foul, they stop the drive, and that is well worth it.
And you know, the Indians over here, they're definitely making the majority of their momentum all off of fast break points.
Yeah, if the Cougars are going to slow down these Indians, they're really going to have to kill that fast break a lot quicker.
Absolutely.
They are, definitely.
It's a major key.
As another three.
Behind the arc, another three for the Shawnee Mission North Indians.
As DJ Khaled once said, another one.
They must have eaten their three O's this morning.
Man.
As Jamie Fisher will drive, nice spin move and
basket.
A horrible shot, but great rebound.
Ooh.
And
that one's in the Raptors.
I honestly don't know what he was shooting at on that one.
It was close. 6 feet.
Close to the moon.
That was close to the moon indeed. As North with the ball.
Here we come. Looks like we're going to actually set up some offense here. First up, we got Danley Bradley with the ball. Michael cutting down to Will, who shoots the short shot, not able to make it, and rebounded by Northwest.
Dylan Dirks with the ball. Now he's going to have to catch on fire here if they want to come back, at least make this game close on senior night. I remember last season, senior night, they had not won in the whole month of February. They come out underdogs and were able to win that night. Maybe they're able to pull off as underdogs again tonight as a wild pass by North out of bounds. Northwest ball. As checking the game for Northwest, number 41, Noah Kendall. He will take over the duties of Austin Sanders. Here we go, Jamie Fisher bringing the ball up court. It looked like a pick, but no. As the ball is deflected out of bounds, and they're going to say Northwest ball. Tipped out by North. With 53.1, Northwest has only scored 5 points this quarter. You can't do that and get away with a dub. As Northwest with the ball, Jamie Fisher to inbound. Finds Jamie Dirks, passes it back to Fisher. Noah Kendall up top. I don't know why he's playing up top. He should get down low. Ferdinand Haney driving in, and a block call. Before he ever got to the rim. Free throws on the way, I believe. Free throws for Noah Kendall. And Noah Kendall struggles from the line, 32%. He's sort of like a DeAndre Jordan up there. He just can't find it. Actually, no, my bad. It is a pass and not a free throw opportunity. Jamie Fisher with the ball, drives the lane and can't hit it.
Just a little too much, just a little too much.
He did a good job of driving the lane, just cannot finish. North will get the final possession in the half, trying to go up.
Here we go with 23 seconds left. Let's see what North can do with this final possession of this quarter. I'm telling you, a three right here would absolutely be a dagger.
Yes, it would. Yes, it would.
Here we go, driving inside. Oh, and it looks like he just
the ball out of the bounds.
A lot of frustration there by Danny Bradley, and reasonably so. It's definitely would be a big score there for them.
As he Ferdinand. Ferdinand throws it, tries to help court shot that is out of bounds. At the end of the first quarter, North 17, Northwest 5.
All right, now we're going to actually throw it over to our sideline reporter, Adam, with a fan, Northwest fan. Send it to you, Adam.
So I'm Adam McMorris, and I'm here with Ron Kopp, one of the captains of the student section. How do you think tonight's going so far?
Right now the team's not playing as well as we'd like them to, but we're still cheering them on, we're still excited, we're still energetic.
Do you guys feel like you add something special to Northwest and help us win?
I really think we do. I think our spirit is uncomparable. I don't think a lot of schools have the spirit we have, so it's exciting. It's fun.
Are you going to break out the big flag tonight?
We are breaking out the big flag at halftime. We always do for big games. So.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
All right, thank you, Adam. And you know, that's...
And that's true. As the first half ends, North up by 12, but again, three quarters of basketball left. If Northwest can just get some easy shots going. Right now, they can't get anything going on offense, and they're ending up chucking up threes or wild layups.
Again, I'd like to return to my key to the game, which I said was get an early lead, and North has done just that. And let's see if they'll be able to hold on to that for the rest of this game here.
Very much indeed. North will get the ball to start the second quarter. 8 minutes are on the clock, and let's party, folks. North with the ball.
All right, here goes Michael with the ball. He's kicking it over to Avante, who swings it down to Marcus. He's down on the corner. Kicks it to his brother on the corner. Spin move, pass down to the middle. Drive up. Whoa. Surprise, there's not a foul there.
Boy.
Avante Williams looks like he got fouled hard there.
The refs are letting him play tonight, it looks like. Ferdinand Haney with the ball.
No call.
Yeah, I don't know about that no call, but maybe it was all ball. Maybe it was.
34 passes it. as Ferdinand driving, and another turnover ball loose. Oh. And a kick ball on. They're going to give the ball to Northwest. Looks like. As even the teachers over there are not happy with that call. Again, the refs have a better viewpoint than us. I'm going to trust them in calling the game.
Yeah, I'd like to know what that rule is now. I'm kind of curious.
Kicks it back out to Jalen O'Day. Jalen O'Day at the top of the key. As he drives the lane, a little shake and bake for Jalen.
Nice fingertip roll there. Nice fingertip.
My X factor of the game.
What a drive.
Charge is called. As he just mows over Jalen O'Day like he is a deer on an interstate highway. Northwest will get the ball. Northwest the ball, Jamie Fisher takes the ball up, pass it to Jalen O'Day, Noah Kendall at the top. Ooh, that spin move, good. I like the idea there, just not executed correctly. Wouldn't you guys say?
I would definitely agree with you, Matt, definitely.
Absolutely, so here comes North down the court again.
Yeah, it was a ride of this, swing it around, get out of driving through the lane, but it didn't work that time, got away from him.
And here goes North setting up the offense. They're going to try to spread out the zone real tight. Try to get a nice pass down low. Here comes Brendan Henderson. Kicks back out to Marcus Weathers. He'll try to drive in. Kicks that out to Brendan, who will shoot from the top of the key just off the rim. Northwest rebounds.
Brendan Hay driving it up. Ooh. Looks like he got all ball there.
Almost stole some cookies.
He's a little bit shaky over there, yeah.
Definitely. A little four-court press North is bringing. That's a Jalen O'Day. Jalen O'Day throws it away.
Ball gets away from, that's two possessions in a row. Those are things that the Northwest offense cannot keep doing if they want to get back into this game.
Certainly. Good point, Reed. As North will get the ball to start here.
Man, I'll tell you what, right now, both these teams' student sections are absolutely ridiculously loud. It's a great game. I'm loving the atmosphere so far. I hope that it can really turn out to be a good game here as Brendan has the ball out on the side of the key.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I'm genuinely impressed by the showing of North here in an away game. It's definitely a really, really cool atmosphere at this rivalry game.
And here goes Avante Williams driving into the lane and gets fouled hard to the floor.
A smart play. Smart play. Drive through the lane, draw the foul, get the free throws.
And that has kind of been North's strategy all year long.
Yeah.
Drive it in, rake in the fouls, and shoot as many free throws as possible.
As Avante Williams, he is a 63% free throw shooter, pretty good at the stripe, as he will shoot two here. His first shot.
Just
as no good. Second shot, Jalen O'Day checks back in. Avant at the free throw line again. His second shot on the way. And it is no good. Rebound by Austin Sanders. And North, even though you got a 10-point lead, you can't miss easy buckets like that. As Jamie Fisher with the ball. Passes out to Austin Sanders. Austin Sanders, good idea, but bad, risky pass. They're driving.
Wow, no call. Surprise on that one. Marcus gets the rebound anyways,
there's
and he goes up strong.
As
got
this
players
game
on the floor.
Is
man, this is going to be gonna be an aggressive one here as the game goes on. And, a lot of defense. We're halfway through with the second quarter, and we haven't even gotten through 30 points yet.
Now, it's been a very defensive game right here. Very physical, old-school basketball.
Absolutely.
And he's 62% on the year. And North misses another free throw. They don't call him free for nothing. We got to make those.
Christian Gallardi checks in. He's another player to watch. He's only a sophomore. He has handles like a god. As if he can develop his shooting motion a little bit better, he can be a star in the upcoming years. As misses another one.
That is four in the row. They're just giving the ball over to here to Northwest. And Northwest needs to start taking control and get some points up on the board.
Certainly.
Those are the types of things. I mean, come on, guys.
you can't turn the ball over like that. You just can't. You got to at least put a shot up, whether crazy or wild. And I believe Rose is going to say that as he does not look happy, and I don't blame him.
Absolutely right.
This team is not playing well. They're not even missing shots right now. They're not even creating opportunities. And they're not getting back in transition defense and having to foul. Luckily, they've been saved by North missing four straight free throws.
Yeah, absolutely. If they would have knocked down those free throws, it could be a whole a different game altogether. I mean, given they're getting a lot of turnovers from Northwest, that's definitely going to their favor. We'll see how that plays out as the game goes on.
Sure.
If Northwest is able to hold on to the ball a little more. But
sure.
So far, North has definitely shown his dominance right now.
Certainly the case. As the timeout breaks, no substitution for the Cougars, as North will get the ball to start.
And you know, it almost seems like we're here at a stalemate. Nobody's scoring. It's all just straight defense. It's all turnovers. It's all fouls. This missed shots, missed everything. We'll see if some offense can start playing now.
And it kicks out to Michael Weathers on the post, on the edge of the key. And we got a traveling call. That's something you definitely don't see too much.
As another turnover by North, and that's going to cost them down the road. Dylan Dirks driving the ball up. He's going to be point guard here. They need to get a basket. They desperately need one. Because North is not going to be able not turn the ball over all night long. Austin Sanders kicks it back out to Dylan Dirks. Dylan Dirks driving the spin move. And yes!
There's some points. There we go.
I don't know if I should call that a shake and bake or a post and toast. But whatever it is, it was impressive.
Maybe a combination of both.
Definitely.
Wow, now, that was... Some
what a layup by Marcus Weathers there. He got down and got strong.
That was a post and toast.
I think that was a spin and win, rather.
Dylan Dirks with the ball. As he is in the corner, no help. Trap finds an open man. Pump fake, kicks it back out to Sanders, resetting the offense. Noah Kendall in the corner, not really a threat from three. Kicks it back out. Zach Smith. And no, not that bad of a shot because he's a decent three-point shooter. North with the ball.
Driving in, no call. Wow, and Northwest somehow ended up with that with the ball at the end of that one.
As they're letting them play today, they are. Dylan Dirks driving the lane, foul, can't finish though. Looks like a little bump there by North. Foul on number, I believe, 13, Avant Williams? Yes, Avant Williams with the foul. Dylan Dirks will be shooting two.
And that will be his second foul.
Yes.
Not a substitution. Sorry about that.
As he hits the first free throw. Dylan Dirks.
69% free throw shooter.
So
we'll see if he can get both of these in now.
Yes, certainly. So here we go, Dylan Dirks with the second opportunity. As he misses it.
Just a bit off.
Here comes North down the floor with the ball. Michael goes up. Hard drive. No finish. Again, rebound, no finish. Brendan Henderson somehow got the ball. And Michael goes up and is fouled hard. By number 32 on the Cougars.
Again, another turnover by Northwest. Leads to the drive from North. That is costly right there. Michael Weathers, he's impressive. I think he is, if not the best, only second to his brother in Eastern Kansas.
He shoots 70% from the free throw line.
Yes,
so let's see what he's able to do here. Finally, a North make on a free throw.
The first make, they're 1 of 5 in the line tonight, and that is not going to help them out at all. Subbing in Jalen LeDay.
Here we go. Let's see if he can improve his team's free throw percentage here.
You know, I don't know the last time I saw being 29 points scored this late in the varsity game.
This looks like a freshman game right now.
Yeah. Just hit 30 points, man.
It's been constant. It's been around that 10-point lead all game. So North right now can put the dagger in Northwest, but they haven't been able to do it. Northwest is still lingering around right now. As Dylan Dirks trying to drive, he kicks it back out to Christian Gilardi for the three.
Ooh.
And
that one.
He may have been way downtown, but he shot that like he was a couple cities away.
Oh, man.
Christian Galari with the rebound makes up for it, though. He's going to drive. Ooh, nice ball handles. He's got some handles on him.
Scrappy little player.
I remember on the old days I used to play him at elementary school.
Gable.
In the Gable leagues, he used to dominate pretty well, I'll say. Back out to Austin Sanders. Dylan Dirks for three. No, and they are not getting inside. They're shooting threes. That's not how you win basketball.
Down the floor comes North. Kicked out to Brendan Henderson for the three. Whoa. No good.
Goodness.
Looks like North will get the ball back. Michael Weathers taking out up top. And let's set up the offense here. Again, my key point to the game, North has gotten to this lead, but they definitely need to expand on it. They cannot sit back and just participate in this game. They have to score some more. Looks like North is going to get the ball back right here off of deflection.
We got number 5 for them, Handy, and number 10, Jamie Fisher, substituting in for the Cougars.
This is a big stop for the Cougars if they can stop him here.
What a drive in there. And off the backboard too hard. Looks like Cougars will get the ball.
Ferdinand Handy taking the ball up. He will be the point guard in position. Passes Jamie Fisher back out to Dylan Dirks on the key. Jalen Ledet up top. They're not getting inside, though. They're staying on the perimeter. Ferdinand driving the Kobe and can't get the friendly bounce. Jamie Fisher, the hustle play, can't get to it.
Here comes North down the floor again. Another quick break. No numbers, though. Kicks back up top here. Shot by Michael and
man,
too hard.
Man, nothing is fine. Got a lid on the bucket today or something.
Absolutely.
I mean, the rim has feelings too. We gotta put that in there.
The iron is unkind.
Yep. As Jalen
Ledet. Oh, what a steal.
Oh,
almost.
Gets the ball back. And
great recovery by Jalen Ledet. And then the
pass
steal.
Down the floor. Here we go. 2-on-1.
And no.
What a flop. And the jam by Marcus Weathers.
I don't know about the no call, but
I don't know either. At least call it a block, I think, on that one. There's a lot of contact there.
I mean, Marcus Weathers did get some style points, so credits to him. Charge, block, whatever it may have been, or nothing. Still got the dunk.
And that's a foul called block on number 2, Will Schneider. As we Northwest down by 13 points here with 44.8 to go. They need to hit these two free throws, of course, and play some defense. Two dunks been given up on them all night. 2 degrees from dunking on you. You can't do that and win basketball games, especially
Absolutely.
Against a high-caliber team like North, as Dirk knocks down the first one. He's a good free-throw shooter from the line, shooting about 70%. That's with 44.8 to go. Dylan Dirk's second one as they put in Noah Kendall for a little height on the rebound if he misses. As I don't know when the last time Northwest has scored 11 points and a half.
That would be an interesting stat to have right now.
It would be. As second one rims out.
Riddling and rattling. No good, though.
As again, the rim has feelings. Not letting any shots in tonight.
It's looking like North is going to take the final possession here in this first half.
And North will waste out the last 45 seconds of the half.
Oh, maybe not.
Maybe not.
Driving in for an easy layup. Mm-hmm. I believe that was Avante Williams in for the shot.
Jamie Fisher driving, trying to get quick points.
No communication there by the Cougars.
Throws it away. Northwest just looks out of sync tonight.
Yeah, definitely right. I mean, only 11 points in the first half. That's, you can't do that. Like you were saying, against a high caliber team such as the Indians.
You can't really do that against an average team, especially not a team like North.
That's absolutely correct.
As they'll hold the last possession.
We got 5 seconds on the clock, and he pulls up for three. And it's off the rim. We got one more shot and the foul at the last second.
Oh, man. Whew. Are they going to call the foul before the half? Yes, they are.
So they call the foul, but it is a shooting foul indeed as the time ran out. And Northwest fans are not happy about that one.
I wouldn't be either. I think time expired before that foul. It was clearly a foul, but I believe after the whistle. As 24... Michael Weathers shoots 2 free throws. His first one is a brick. Again, there's 2 stats that are interesting tonight. I've never seen North miss this many free throws.
I mean, recall the brick house, but not on the free throw line.
And I've never
or anywhere
seen
on the basketball court.
Score 11 points as he hits the second one. And that will do it for the end of the first half. The score, North 26, Northwest 11. As we're heading off to halftime intermission. Sort of a sloppy game in the first half by both teams.
You're
really
absolutely right. You know, what is it, 11 to 25, something
yeah,
like that? I haven't seen a varsity basketball game that low scoring. I don't know if I ever have in the first half. I mean, it's just a lot of sloppy passes, a lot of forced baskets, and neither team is having a lot of luck on the offensive end. But I don't know if it's good defense or if it's a lot of bad shots, but it's a low-scoring game, needless to say.
Right now, Northwest is averaging on pace to score 22 points in the game. That's how many points I scored last time I played a pickup game. They need to step it up. And with North, while North has the lead, they could easily be up by 30 right now.
Absolutely. I would definitely agree with you guys that both teams are definitely not playing to their full potential. I feel like North could really be doing a whole lot more with this. But nonetheless, they still have the lead, but you can't complain too much. But overall, I think that North could definitely improve in the second half as far as turnovers and absolutely on free throws. They've missed quite a few here.
Back to my keys of the game for Northwest. Stop the Weathers brothers. Didn't happen. Attack them offensively in the paint. Didn't happen. They stay on the perimeter.
And you know, the scoreboard shows that, really. It really does.
And don't turn the ball over. Didn't do it. And
man.
They're paying the price on the scoreboard right now. Luckily, they're only down by 14, which is overcome. I mean, you can in two quarters of basketball, but play like they did in the first half, and this game is over.
Absolutely right, yeah. I mean,
if you want to hear, go back to my keys. I would definitely say that North has stuck to mine. Get ahead early. They've done that, and they need to keep it if they want to go on with this win.
Certainly, Grant. They have done that. The only thing I think North needs to improve is first hit free throws. I mean, that's huge. They left 6 points, I believe, out there in free throws.
Not more, yeah.
Another
yeah.
comment, the points off of turnovers. There's been a ton of turnovers, but they really haven't scored off the turnover. And I think if North wants to really come away with a big victory here, they're going to have to capitalize on those opportunities a little more.
North's been creating turnovers, but Northwest has been good about getting back in transition defense and fouling them. And there we go back to the game of North having struggles at the line, or they're able to play good defense. Now, North, as we're going to send it over to the PA announcer right now for senior night.
These are individuals who have entertained us and helped bring spirit to our athletic competitions. Their hours of work and dedication are greatly appreciated. Victoria Alexander. Victoria is escorted by her parents, Kevin and Ginger Alexander. She has been a member of the cheer program for 4 years. Upon graduation, she plans to attend Pittsburgh State University to major in elementary education. Rachel Barnes. Rachel is escorted by Amy Barnes. She has been a member of the cheer squad the past 3 years. Upon graduation, Rachel plans to go to Kenya with Outreach International to volunteer at an orphanage. Marissa Nichelle Birch. Marissa is escorted by Scott Smith and mother Michelle Birch. Marissa has been in the cheer program the past 4 years. Upon graduation, she plans to pursue a degree in elementary education from Ottawa University. Heather Grayson. Heather is escorted by her parents, Phil and Lisa Grayson. She's been a member of the cheer program for the past 4 years. Upon graduation, Heather plans to attend University of Mississippi to study elementary education and potentially pursue cheer. Madison Elise Charman, who is not present but wanted to be recognized. Madison has been a part of the Cougar Cheer Squad the past 4 years. Upon graduation, she plans to attend Kansas State University to major in business and management with a minor in leadership studies. Katie Martin. Katie is escorted by Mike and Kathy Martin. She has been a member of the cheer squad for 4 years. Upon graduation, she plans to pursue pre-med, but is uncertain at what post-secondary institution. Taylor Moore. Taylor is escorted by her parents, Ted and Kim Moore. She has been a member of the cheer squad the past 4 years. Upon graduation, Taylor is undecided upon what post-secondary institution she plans to attend, but she wants to pursue a degree in political science. Ethan Nelson. Ethan is escorted by Chris and Kate Clark. He has been a member of the squad for the past 3 years. Upon graduation, Ethan plans to attend Johnson County Community College to study in agriculture. Cammie Payne. Cammie is escorted by her mother, Patty Payne. She has been a member of the cheer squad for the past 4 years. Upon graduation, she plans to attend Johnson County Community College. Katie Scott. Katie is escorted by her mother, Melissa Scott. She has been on the squad all 4 years. Upon graduation, Katie plans to attend Kansas State University and study strategic communications. Katie Sprang. Katie is being escorted by her parents, Steve and Tina Sprang. Katie has been a part of the cheer squad all 4 years. Upon graduation, Katie will pursue criminology, but is unsure as to what post-secondary institution she will attend. Nadia Williams. Nadia is escorted by Carrie Muhammad and Waltia Williams. She has been a part of the Cougar Cheer Program for 2 years. Upon graduation, she plans to study Spanish and French at Johnson County Community College prior to attending Wichita State University. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give one more big round of applause for the time, effort, and pure entertainment that these fine individuals have offered to us through their tenure at Shawnee Mission Northwest. Congratulations to you all. You're all perfect.
Hey, so we're back. We're going to throw it over to an interview on the side with Eddie.
So we're here today with Mr. Lede, who just had his son come down, and he's been playing for Northwest Basketball for a couple years. What was it like watching your son and walk down with them for the last time here?
You know, it's bittersweet. I mean, he's had a long road. He's done some good things, and to see him make it to this point and be a part of the team and play as well as he's played, you know, it's bittersweet because this is it. This is it.
Do you feel like you guys have a special bond now through basketball and through watching him play here that like no other son has here?
Well, our bond goes a little deeper because we ride to school every morning. We ride home every night. I'm hanging around sometimes at practice, but you know, that bond goes deep. I played a little high school basketball and just talking with him and coaching him since he was a little kid and growing up and seeing the player he's become now, you know, it's nice to see.
Thank you, Mr. Lede. It's been good. Back over to the desks. Thank you.
Thank you, Adam, for that report. We're back now, halftime. How does Northwest get back in this game?
Well, first of all, it would definitely help if the Indians kept on missing those free throws and making those few turnovers that they've been making. And also, Northwest can't continue to keep making these really crucial turnovers that they've been, just bad passes, just careless mistakes, and just can't finish, can't compose through to make a basket. That's a major, major key that they need to fix in order to win this game.
Absolutely, I agree. If Northwest is going to get back, they've got to start limiting turnovers. They've got to start making their shots. But they do have to also keep playing tough. You can tell they're playing tough by the number of fouls, even though they are currently down, as you see, 26-11 to the Indians of Shawnee Mission North.
I agree 100% with those comments. Can they get back? Yes, there's still 16 minutes of basketball left, but they got to come out hot. Don't need threes. You can still drive inside, get twos, but play solid defense, good transition defense. If you're able to get back and defend them, you have a chance to come back in this game.
Absolutely. Again, Northwest has to remember that you do not need threes at this point. They're nice, but what they really need is to drive inside, get the easy looks, and limit those turnovers so
Absolutely.
They can prevent North from scoring.
Yeah, I agree.
And
overall, North, however, if they would like to come out of this game with another win and to secure their only top spot at the top of the Sunflower League and remain undefeated, they're really going to have to keep playing strong, keep being physical, and continue to stretch the zone offense or zone defense of the Shawnee Mission Northwest Cougars.
Yeah, North's been very impressive. This is a hostile home arena, and they've been able to come here and quiet the crowd throughout.
And you know, it's hostile, but if you look over the student section, they've made it their own home. Like,
true.
There's just as many Indians as there are Cougars. It's impressive.
Yeah, they do travel well. Granted, it's only about 10-minute drive over here.
Yeah, uh-huh. It's not far at all. So it's really not like too big of an away game. I guess a lot of the students are really just trying to show their support for our basketball team, especially heading into the sub-state time. So we're definitely looking forward to continuing this win and coming out of here with another
and
dub.
You know, that may be attributed to the 6-1 record, the 6-1 away record that the Indians have right now, and that having a student section follow you everywhere you go is definitely a huge help in any way possible.
That's true. Right now, Indians will most likely be the top seed in this sub-state tournament going in the state. Most likely, they'll probably fall for the state tournament. Northwest is going to have to play two road games on the road to state. That is going to be hard.
Well, actually, correction. Although the North will most likely win the Sun, or they already have the top spot in the Sunflower League, that does not mean they'll necessarily have the top seed in sub-state, as the sub-state is based off of overall records. So most likely North will fall to the second spot in sub-state, while Lawrence High School will have that top spot. But either way, again, like you said, North will most likely have two home games, and Northwest will most likely have two away games.
And it's hard to go on the road in the Sunflower League, as we know, but North is showing how to do it tonight.
Definitely. So again, back to our keys of the game. I'm gonna stick with the same keys for the second half. They've got to explode early, maybe a good dunk on a transition, or even a long range three could really shift them or keep the momentum rolling their way.
And you know, I mean, the keys for North are honestly kind of the same keys for Northwest. If Northwest can have, you know, one good offensive transition and drive the ball down, get a dunk, get a good controversial call going their way, that's enough on a home court. That's enough to completely turn around the feel and the way that you're playing this game. And I mean, that can just make all the difference.
You're very right, Reed. A turning point can happen at any moment, whether a foul, a three-point, a dunk, or maybe a technical foul.
Northwest needs that turning point in order to win this game.
And they need it sooner than later.
Yeah, absolutely right.
As Northwest will inbound the ball, and we'll start the second half. Jamie Fisher will get the call at point guard. Score 26-11, Shawnee Mission North on top as we start the third quarter. As there's, again, I think that was to Dirks, but again, the miscommunication, too much.
What a Euro step by Michael. Oh, and the rebound was just missed by Brendan Henderson.
Ferdinand Henning dribbling the ball up, trying to look.
Turnover.
And that's a turnover and a layup for North.
Those are the transitions we're talking about. That can make and break you.
That's true. Jalen Lede wide open, misses a shot over the back call on Austin Sanders.
Fun little fact going back to the last play the North had. Not too many people can play both varsity quarterback and starting varsity for their high school. And that's something that Will Schneider has been able to do and has really been able to do quite effectively.
Yeah.
That is very true. If you're Jalen Lede, you cannot miss that shot right there. You're wide open, little 10-foot jumper. You got to make that shot.
Absolutely. So here goes North again. Oh, it looks like a turnover. Nope, maybe not. Knocked away, but it is going Northwest way.
Looks like Jamie Fisher ran right into the North bench over there.
As it is North ball, I believe?
I thought they called Northwest, but
nope,
maybe not.
They're calling North ball.
All right. So North will keep it down there. Inbounding is number 13, Avante Williams. And kicking up top to Michael Weathers. Avante Williams now at the point. Kicks around to Brendan, swung around to the post to Marcus. Driving in by Michael for the layup, and it's good.
Another good basket by Shawnee Mission North as they start off this half with a 4-0 run. Jamie Fisher with the ball, driving up court.
A little stutter step.
Finds Jalen Ferdinand in the lane, drives, can't finish. Austin with the rebound. Trying to go up, he does with a nice basket.
That was a nice little comeback bucket for Northwest.
That was a that's what we like to call a post and toast right there by Austin Sanders. And
like
North,
they got a little tangled up down there on the other end.
No foul called, good call as both players went for the ball and they got tripped up. But North, I like the idea of going for the Hail Mary, the baseball pass right there. Maybe you should have slowed it down, but it was a good risk.
I don't know, when you're up by 17, sometimes you just look for the dagger right away and it looks like they just went a little too far.
Sure.
So it's something like that, make a game just go way downhill.
Offensive foul called on Dylan Dirks there. I'm not sure where it was. They haven't been calling that all night, but foul on Dirks.
Yeah, the Northwest student section sure got fired up after that one on the inbound. But here North goes to set up the offense again.
Oh,
down inside, Marcus almost turning it over, goes up for a strong shot, bricked off the backboard. It looked like, not exactly sure what the call was there.
And there's a foul on, they're gonna say a push off. He was number 5 there.
Marcus Weathers.
Nope, the foul is gonna be called on Will Schneider.
Oh.
Foul of the game. That's huge for the North.
For both teams, it's just been a lot of sloppy play, a lot of balls rolling around, everybody's diving for the balls. You know, you love seeing that, but.
Got some cookies
another
stolen
Another play,
here.
And we're gonna see a layup. Simple.
There it is, and as you can see, North is starting to break away. It was a, 12-point lead, and now it's gone to a
17-point lead right here. They really need a basket here. Jalen Lede gets in.
I'm sorry, 19-point lead.
Okay. He misses another one.
Here goes North down the floor, seeing what they can do on this offensive drive.
Ooh, rejected. Up. That's a turkey on Thanksgiving right there.
North still got the ball and got the blocking call for them.
That's true, and Austin Sanders is slow to get up.
That's not something you like to see for the Nebraska Wesleyan commit.
No, you do not. He will be a prairie dog next year playing for Nebraska Wesleyan University. As he's okay, he gets up.
He's a fighter.
He is very much. As North, Avante Williams shooting 2.
So,
let's see if North can try to end their struggles at the free throw line. Right now, both fan bases are very intrigued to the game.
Oh, it was not a shooting foul.
No shooting foul called. I thought it was. and then North throws it away. That was almost as bad as that Austin Sanders play in the first half.
Sure.
As substitution. Substitution for North here. Jamie Fisher bringing the ball up. As he's looking for a man to pass to, finds Dirks in the corner for a three.
Nice
yes!
corner pocket three by there.
Nothing
from
but
downtown.
Net.
And Dirks out there giving his all. It's senior night. He's going to give it all.
Ooh.
And
student section did not like that call.
I don't know if I like that call.
It looked a little ticky-tacky to me.
Oh yeah.
It did. If they would have been calling that foul all night, I would have had no problem with that. But that's the first call they fouled on a couple of instances Excellent. Where it could have been called.
Uh-huh.
North will get the ball as their student section leader Ron Kopp down there leading the charge.
Ooh.
And that must
having
be
having a little bit of controversy there between the who's that? Michael? Michael and the student section of Shawnee Mission Northwest, a little bit of taunting.
A little bit of rivalry here. We didn't see this much hatred in the girls game as that was a blowout from the beginning. And this, 16 points, but both teams are still
starting to become a blowout, yeah.
Tim's ball coming down.
Dylan Dirks gets the ball, driving down the court. Ferdinand drives and
nice shot.
Throws up a wild shot.
Offensive
Austin
rebound.
Sanders, great
good
rebound.
No call, attaboy, Austin. There you go.
Austin down low gets the rebound and the bucket. As it looks like they're playing a little full court trap. They get out of that easily.
Oh boy.
And he's running.
Holy posterized. Boom goes the dynamite.
He just earned his degree from dunking on you right there on that one. Is that his second dunk of the night?
I believe so. Slamming and jamming for you.
Definitely handy for three. Can't
trying
silence
to bounce
the North
back.
Crowd.
Can't do it. Yes, that is absolutely
that
right.
That just might have been the dagger we were talking about earlier.
Oh, but a turnover by. And Jamie Fisher pops up a three.
Try it
no.
Again.
They have got to stop shooting threes. It's going to be an inbounds play as foul on Shawnee Mission North. I mean, don't you guys agree? Northwest has got to stop shooting threes. They're not
and
hitting
well,
them at
I
all.
Mean, it's not the threes, it's the forced threes. They're trying to come down to the fast break, and they're just pulling up at a three pointer when they could just drive and get the safe shot. You don't want to be going for the risky shots right now. You want to be playing good old school ball.
Very true.
Make
very
the
true.
High percentage shots.
Kicks it back out. Jamie Fisher got hit on the hand, no call. As Jalen Ledet with the finger roll. As the score is 22-34.
Ooh. As we approach the 3 minute mark here coming up in the third quarter.
Another blocking foul call.
Seven and one, yeah.
Wow, boy. North is just driving down inside mercilessly. And they are getting all sorts of calls going their way because of it.
That is very true. Right now they're just attacking the rim. That was the key to the game for Northwest. But North is doing it right now.
Uh-huh.
As a talks to his player real quick.
Sounds like a master key.
The first shot is no good, but the rebound.
Nice tip in. That 4 point play. As a man once said, it's huge.
Man, Northwest needs to build a wall down there. Let's stop them from scoring.
Thrown away. No tip, and it's going North's way.
I guess they want the student section getting
involved. I got a question. What was that?
I guess they saw people in white and decided to throw the ball to them. I don't know.
Sounds about right. So here comes North again with the ball. Up top, we got Danny Bradley passing over to Avante Williams. Back to Danny. Driving in, kicked out to Marcus, or to Michael, wide open.
Talk about a spicy pass right there. That was
Definitely.
Impressive.
And you leave Michael open for three, and 9 times out of 10, he's going to hit that shot.
May I say, boom goes the dynamite.
They'll bring it up to a 21-point lead for the Indians here.
As a foul called.
Boy, I tell you, I mean, the score, again, it doesn't show it, but the Cougars are still really fighting here hard.
Absolutely.
They are, but they got to start. They're down by 21. There's only about 10 minutes left in the game. They got to start scoring and playing defense. And with North's recent struggle at the free throw line, may help them down the line if the game gets, you know, within 5 to 6 points. Ooh, Jamie missed a cut right there by Austin. Noah gets hacked by number 24, Michael Weathers.
Yeah, it looks like he definitely got a little reach-in foul right there.
And that is his third foul, Michael Weathers.
You'll definitely have to keep an eye on that.
Not backcourt, I guess. Yep, not backcourt.
Yeah, as long as the ball's not in possession on the one half, that's not a backcourt
For a second, I was wondering who Jamie was throwing to, and then I saw Dirk's back there. Noah Kendall with the ball at the top. Passes it to Zach Smith. Zach Smith trying to look for an open man.
Oh, boy, picking off.
He finds an open north man. And
that was a nice shot of the ceiling, but I'm sure he made the point.
True that. Jamie Fisher with the ball. 23-point game. Austin Sanders down low. Gets it.
Another
stripped.
Steal. Another one. And another one.
And a foul called down low. Nice crossover move.
A little bit of frustration there by Jamie Fisher. A little bit of hooting and hollering from both crowds.
Absolutely. The administrators are starting to walk around a little bit.
Yep.
I mean, if you don't see the score of this game, it looks like it's a close fought game, but if you know, 23 points right now, that's going to be hard to overcome, certainly. Uh-huh.
That's what rivalries are all about.
Oh, toilet bowl flush right there.
This is a lucky ring around with that shot. As Ferdinand Henney checks into the game for Austin Sanders. Second free throw from Michael Weathers.
Again, Michael Weathers is 70% of the free throw line, so that's definitely impressive.
If he hits the shot,
he'll shoot down the second one of the after the missed first.
Indians are doing a little better hitting the free throws this quarter.
Yeah, definitely. And it's showing with the score here, 25-point lead.
It certainly has. Jamie Fisher with the ball up. And I don't think this is how Northwest seniors want to go out their last game.
Definitely,
you know, they got
not.
Dylan for three.
A brick.
I mean, that was another forced three right there.
Absolutely. Like we said earlier, they need to remember that threes are not the only way they can get back in.
And I think
North
called a timeout before he stepped out of bounds.
30-second timeout called by the Indians. Recently, Shawnee Mission Northwest Athletic Program has undertaken a project of adopting All-Stars for the Pinky Swear program, which are pediatric cancer patients. Pinky Swear pays non-medical expenses such as a mortgage or rent payment, a car payment, and gas or food cards to help families. Help support your team and the All-Stars by making a donation. For more information, go to smnorthwest@smsd.org.
And we're back to the action with North on top of this game, 45-20 with a minute 38 to go in the game.
The third quarter, actually.
Third quarter, my bad, pardon me.
Very good. Well, again, here we go. Will Schneider inbounding the ball for the Indians here. Peeling inbounded up to Avante. We'll kick it out to Andrew Gonzalez, who's getting his first minutes of the game. Not sure. I've never seen that call before. It looks like a karate chop.
I have
got a charge.
A charge is called. Okay. I was wondering what that call was for a second.
It's a little bit of an interesting gesture, but hey, whatever works.
Absolutely. Either way, Northwest is having the ball right now, coming up the floor.
Jamie Fisher, is taking the ball up the court. Trying to look around and moving screen, I think.
Another offensive foul.
I believe
Cougars number 23, Zach Smith.
Zach Smith with the moving screen there, I believe. Can't do that. You get turnover from North, and you can't turn it back over.
Absolutely right.
So here you go. Looks like number 11, Andrew Gonzalez, inbounding to number 1, Danny Bradley. Bradley's driving down the floor. Crossovers. Up to Will Schneider.
Nice double team there by the Cougars. Still got away from it, though.
Into Danny Bradley, kicks it over to Schneider. Looked like he might have pulled up there for a second, but drives inside, kicks it out to Gonzalez. Bounce over to Will Schneider for the three, and short.
And that will be Northwest ball.
You know, it's looking like the Cougars are working on a different kind of defense here. It's a lot more double teams and pressure up on the Indians.
That's what they're going to have to do in order to come back at all.
They got to create some turnovers and get some easy buckets. Because when they get in the set offense, they've not been creating opportunities to score. They've been forcing up threes. 50 seconds to go, Northwest ball. Noah Kendall down low.
Wide open shot. And off the front.
That's the thing.
See, that's the three I don't mind. He's wide open.
Yeah.
But you got to hit it.
But the problem is that Northwest needs to take advantage of those easy buckets. They're forcing the buckets that are not being made, and then they're taking the easy ones and just
throwing them
not
away.
Not composing. Absolutely right.
I think Jamie Fisher just tried a flop there. I guess try everything again there.
You know it. So here goes Marcus Weathers. Passing over down inside to 11.
Ooh.
And he got called for the foul. It's a senior, Andrew Gonzalez. He's not seeing a lot of playing time that often, but he's definitely making a little bit of a mark tonight.
Right now, Northwest looks spent. They look tired. One quarter left. As in missed free throw there by number 11.
Too many bicep curls, went a little too far.
That's true. He hit the weight room too much.
Coming into this game, Andrew has only attempted two free throws. That was his third. And now
he
is exactly 50% on the year.
That's not too bad for a big man like him.
Yeah, not too bad.
Dylan Dirks with the screen off Noah Kendall. Pass back to Zach Smith. Another three and another miss.
Balled.
Oh, they're going to say that was tipped by North. Still.
That's fine. Here goes Marcus driving in. So they pulled out to Andrew. Oh, so close for the three.
No good.
With a put back jam. Oh, he's down though. That does not look good.
That is not something that North likes to see.
North student section is going off, but it looks like the player is down on the floor. Oh, he just got up.
If that play doesn't summarize the third quarter, I don't know what does.
Absolutely.
Hustle by North, putting it all out with that dunk right there.
He is a warrior.
And right now we're going to the Brinney with the Rose sisters out to Adam McMorris.
So I'm here with Emily Rose and Brinney Rose, who just got done playing their last game here at home for the season. Emily, how do you think it went tonight?
We pulled through. We got the W against Shawnee Mission North, which is a rival team. So I mean, it was nice to pull through and get that last W on our.
What's it been like playing with your sister and? How's it like bonded with you guys?
Brittany and I are really close, and we played together for like a long time. I mean, it started in the driveway, and then my dad's obviously a coach, and so we've been around it forever. And Brittany and I have this like little connection that like no one else has, so it's really easy to play with her, and we just have a chemistry.
Brittany, where do you guys plan for sub-state here and state? What are you guys' plans here?
Well, we were able to clinch being able to host sub-state, which is good for us, being able to play at home. And our plans are to win both and go back to state. And, you know, we have to win that first game and then grind through the next two and hopefully be able to pull out three wins.
All right, thank you, guys. Back to the desk.
All right, for more information on the Rose sisters, check out the latest issue of the Northwest Passage. There is an article on them. Now back to the game, North with the ball.
Here we go, swinging over to Gonzalez, who's at the top of the key, passing in to Michael Weathers. Pass down low to Will Schneider, who got stuffed like a Thanksgiving turkey. Back out to Gonzalez, out to Weathers, to the corner for Brendan Henderson. In and out. That one really could have got the student section going back again.
As Jamie Fisher with the ball. As off the screen from Noah Kendall. Zach Smith, another three, and another miss.
Oh,
it looks
goodness,
like deja vu out there.
20-48, North is really, really breaking away in this one.
What a pass down low, just off.
Zesty.
And you, again, both teams are hustling out. I think that's,
And it's staying in North.
Zach Smith, he is a warrior out there.
As North, even up by 28, are still going after those loose balls. That's how they got the lead in the first place.
Absolutely. Those are one of those keys that I mentioned earlier. They're going to have to not settle for where they're at. They're going to have to keep driving because this game is still not over. As they go up 50-20.
I've never seen a varsity score this low for Northwest. Dylan Dirks with a nice drive, though. That's what we like to call a little shake and bake.
Absolutely. They've got to get a lot more shaking and baking if they want to come back into this one, though.
They do. They got to crank that oven up to about 450 right now.
Love it, 425, am I right?
They got to crank it up to about 425 in the next 6.5 minutes as North throws it out of bounds.
to our sideline reporter, Adam, over there. The ball boy, almost.
Way to go, Adam. As Jamie Fisher gets the ball up, gets the screen from Noah Kendall. Pass it back. Kendall double-teamed and drives the lane. Zach Smith, good decision not to shoot the three, and he drives the lane.
And that's what we're talking about. You can't just pass up for the contested three. If you drive inside, you will get points sometime.
As a turnover by North. I mean, if Zach Smith, let's take a look. He shot about 4 or 5 threes that have just been not even close. If he takes those in, makes 4 of them, that's 8 points, and it's an 18-point game, and that's somewhat manageable right now.
Yeah.
Fernand Haney with the ball.
That's definitely some looks of stress or despair or something over there on the Northwest bench, not having a fun time.
Fernand Haney off front.
Northwest just cannot have any breaks.
And one.
I mean,
man,
everything is seeming to go the Indians' way.
I think that was a post and toast right there.
I would call it a post and toast.
Okay, I would too. And that's just impressive. That's those summer conditioning programs right there.
Oh, and that's Avante Williams, and he's only a junior this year, so he'll be back another year, and he'll definitely be leading the team next year. So we'll see if he can knock down these couple free throws, one free throw, see what can happen. And he knocks it in.
I've just been told the mercy rule is in play as the clock will continue to run for the rest of the game. There will be no stoppages. Christian Gilardi with the ball. Back up to Jalen Lede.
Nice
Jalen
drive.
Jalen drives, and it's stuffed.
Double stuffed.
And he is fouled.
Double stuffed Oreos
hard.
On that one. Oh, my goodness.
Man, Dylan Dirks hit the floor hard as the clock continues to run. 4:30 to go. Dylan Dirks hits the first free throw. Makes it 25-53. As 4:10 to go as this game winds down. I'm a little shocked. I'm not shocked by North winning. I'm shocked at the fact that North has been able to dominate this game.
Absolutely. I mean, North was a favorite coming in, for sure. But I will say that Northwest has absolutely fought through this whole game, but North has just been dominant in every aspect.
True.
And while, yeah, now North wasn't flawless in that first half, a lot of missed free throws and a lot of sloppy turnovers, and that's a bit of a flop.
Tried to flop like a cold herring in
a
Scandinavia.
Nice shot from Dylan Dirks. How about that, folks? From behind
boy.
The R Yep, as Colton Skeens checks in, so along
as well
with
as Noah Kendall.
Kendall,
yeah.
As Dylan Dirks, Dylan Dirks is staying on the court. Jamie Fisher comes out, which is probably his last time at Northwest, being a senior this year.
And you know, a lot of love for all these guys here at Northwest. It's been a rough season, but you still got to love seeing all this team chemistry.
Just like every other team, you can win a state championship still.
Absolutely.
Got to go on
the
road.
It's not over yet.
No, it's not. Dirks to what? Oh!
Wrong team. I think that was just tipped in by a North player.
I don't know. That was impressive. That was a spicy pass to Jalen, who misses a shot. But Noah Kendall is able to come down there and, you know, touched rim. I'll give him a bring down the house on that one.
And, you know, I admire the heart, especially of Dylan Dirks over here. He's still fighting for every single ball, even after a, 24-point lead by the Indians of North over here.
He's a very resourceful man. And Jalen Love with the bank three.
A little kiss off the glass there.
Can't be celebrating too early, though, as North comes down for another layup on transition.
You know, when Northwest scores, North is on fire in transition offense. There are warriors out there. They're pushing it up. They're up by almost 30 points. They're up by 21 points right now. 2 minutes left, and they're still hustling as hard as they were in the first couple
moments.
And now North
has finally taken out its starters here. Their fans are giving them a big round of applause.
As Dylan Dirks comes out of the game for the last time in his Northwest career at Northwest. Not the way he wants to go out, but he played his heart out tonight.
He may not be the biggest guy on the floor, but he has the biggest heart.
Yeah. He's pretty tall, though.
Hey, How tall is he? We have that stat in here somewhere.
Yes, we do. Dylan Dirks.
6'2".
6'2".
You know, we got Austin Sanders, 6'6". So they'll be playing next year together, though, so that'll be cool for them.
That's true, yeah. That will be a fun time next year for them. Christian Gilardi, point guard. He'll be the point guard next year, most likely, for the Cougars. He looks good. He's real young, real agile.
Ooh, turnover
another
there by
turnovers.
The Cougars.
It almost looks like this JV matchup here that's broken out. It looks a lot like the varsity. Looks like a pretty good mirror of what happened earlier on in the game.
Yeah.
Another silly turnover led by another transition bucket by North.
Joe Speck misses the three. Golden with the nice rebound. As these two games have been really similar to each other.
Absolutely.
Jalen Love! The double dose from behind the arc for him.
Boom goes the dynamite. Wide open,
that
though.
That is true.
Couple missed layups there by the Indians.
As this clock will
won't really like make much of a difference. Yeah, clock's winding down.
As
mercy rule in effect.
As with 15 to go, they might be able to get one shot off. Maybe make this a 20-point game if possible. 12 on the clock, 10 to go. Christian Gilardi with the ball, taking it up court.
He's gonna
and
drive
he's driving
inside.
For Alex Olsen with the three.
Man, they should have put
Alex
him in
Olsen,
earlier.
There he is.
With the three, buries the three to end the game.
We'll have Northwest, Shawnee Mission Northwest Cougars 40, Shawnee Mission North Indians 60.
And for the first time in a very long time, the Shawnee Mission North Indians have gone undefeated in the Sunflower League.
Congratulations to them. That is very impressive.
It's very impressive and one of the best leagues in definitely the state, if not even the whole Midwest region.
Absolutely. So while the score may not show it, I would still argue that Northwest definitely fought hard. Even though the Indians came out of here with a win, it was a great game by both teams. A lot of entertainment. It was a good game overall.
Yep, both games were a little offside today. As the first game, the Northwest girls were able to dominate the North girls, and the opposite in the second game. The North boys were able to dominate the Northwest boys. Closing thoughts, guys. First, I'll go to Grant. Let's talk about this last game we just saw.
Well, this last game that we just saw, I would definitely say that North was able to have the key to the game. Like I said, was get out to a big lead early. And when that happened, they were able to really spread the floor, play their relaxed style of game, and they were really able to just do whatever they wanted on the offensive side. They also manhandled Northwest overall on defense, which really just pushed them over the edge on this one.
That's true. One thing I liked about the North, not even just the Weathers brothers, it was their transition offense. Northwest would get a big bucket, and what would North do? Drive the court, make a nice pass. They would easily get a layup or a wide open shot. That's how they won the game, really. And Northwest turned the ball over too many times to be competitive with a quality, really good quality North team.
And I mean, you know, first half, really, really low score. It ended up being a pretty average scoring game, you know, 100 points total. That's a little under what you usually see. But that first half, the first half was just slow. It was a lot of turned over buckets, a lot of missed opportunities for both teams, a lot of missed layups and free throws, and just you can't have that if you want to win as Northwest. And you know, North did a really good job in the second half taking advantage of the opportunities that they were given.
Certainly, very much. Now back to the, you know, both teams are still alive. They got Substate coming up. Brackets will release tomorrow. North going to be the favorite. Play two games at home.
Absolutely.
Two games at home. Most likely probably going to make a state tournament.
All right, we're going to pass it off to our sideline reporter, Adam.
I'm here from the coach with North. And how do you think you guys played tonight?
Well, I mean, defensively, I thought we played very well. They did some stuff on offense that we don't normally do, but you know, the focus and everything was just trying to beat Northwest, and you know, the kids just played hard, and that's all I got to say about that. I mean, we got to fix some of the things, but it's a good game for us.
What are you guys' plans for Substate and possibly getting to state? What are you guys' plans?
Well, we got to go back to work, and we're gonna just be humble and just work one step at a time. You know, getting a share of some, I mean, getting the Sunflower League title, that was their goal right from the start. And now we just got to go set another goal. But yeah, that's the way it ought to be. And, I mean, they've worked hard, and, you know, team did it.
All right. Thank you, Coach. Thank you. Have a good one.
You know, definitely an impressive season for the Indians. Went 12-0, undefeated for the Sunflower League. That is very impressive. It's not something that you can do every season. It's very rare to see something like that.
That is very rare. One thing about Northwest is I think they still have the possibility to be a Cinderella team in the sub-state tournament and make it to the state tournament. They got the talent. If they get the communication together and stop turning the ball over. That was the number one reason why they lost tonight. They turned the ball over and bad transition defense.
Absolutely. I think they totally still have a shot down the road. If they can just get those turnover issues handled and start hitting the easy shots, I really think they've got a shot in the sub-state tournament coming up here.
And North, I think North is going to be great in the tournament. They got the Weathers brothers who were able to dominate, along with Avante Williams looked good tonight, and also Will Schneider. They both chipped in a lot. They both hustled the ball, able to knock down shots. So I think North is, you know, pretty good in this state tournament. They're definitely going to make state.
And, you know, I can see both teams having a shot. I do see North going very far in the tournament. Mm-hmm. I really do.
I think North has a good opportunity to even bring home a state title.
Yeah. All right. Well, for conclusion, for Matt Owens and Grant Cole, I'm Reed Williams signing off for Shawnee Mission Sports. Have a good one.